exists in the audience. Just going to run a stopwatch on my phone, I guess. So yes, Graze Counter is the second game of my block. I'm just doing a regular, not too fancy run through of this using this character, Coco. She can use the Graze Counter attack while in break mode, which basically lets her stay in break mode even longer. It's pretty great. And begin. So, as the title suggests, the point of this game is you graze shots to charge up a counter attack. Hey, George. This game has like 16 different playable ships in it. A lot of them actually manage to feel pretty distinct, which is kind of an achievement, really. There's one character that can only fight close range with a drill. One of them swings a sword around. One of them has like little drones that auto-fire on things within a set radius whenever you're in the grazing area. Although they kind of nerfed it from the original version of the game. I played the daylights out on the original non-GM version. There are still parts that I think I like better in the original. But overall, it's a solid enough upgrade. You kinda don't need to play the original anymore. If you were coming in new. Screwing that up. If you get into the middle of the circle and then wait for a second, you'll collect all three items. Okay, here's something taken from a game called Chōren Sha that I have never played, but I keep hearing about. I think it wasn't Shmuptember, but probably got run when I was at work. Show me your moves! I honestly think this is the hardest stage. Especially when you fly directly into the barrel of a tank.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
I am shmupping like a cow. Hey, there we go. It's a gas. Oh. There we go. If It feels really good when you, like, get into a loop with this character. When your break mode is going, and you can get the Graze counter charged up and fire it off while the break mode is firing, and it just keeps feeding itself back up. Yeah, this is the demon maid. Her name is Coco. I'm not sure what she's from, or if she's another indie VTuber. A few of the guest characters are. Dancing in my chair for a minute there. Mostly like vertical ones. I do like Death Smiles a lot. I know there's others. I'm just drawing a blank right now. I think a lot of it just comes down to like whether you like stage design or enemy pattern design better when you're playing a game. And I like vertical games because you tend to just be like you and the enemy. Get a little cameo from the rival. Oh. I feel like I've only landed that once today. made in space. For the longest time, I saw the invincible prompt over the boss whenever you use burst mode, and I thought that meant the boss was just, like, immune, like, completely, but it's, like, a temporary shield that goes away after a second. By my stopwatch, I cannot tell time when I give estimates, so... Came closer to like 17 minutes instead of 25. I think it's because I was staying in break mode so much longer with this character. It's okay, though. The last patch to Grand Cross actually made the story path with the main character a little bit longer, so I think I'm gonna end up breaking even by the end of this little block here. I'm gonna go ahead and put up the transition screen here. I'll let the credits theme play out.